In this video, I'm going to explain why Jordan Peterson is 100% wrong. You can increase your intelligence. Now, this is something that Jordan Peterson has claimed many times. He has claimed to have read all of the studies about increasing intelligence, and from that, he has concluded that you can't increase your intelligence. That's what he has claimed many times, and it's one of the main arguments I hear about some of the videos I make. Some people say that you must be wrong, you can't increase intelligence because Jordan Peterson says so, and that's the entire argument. So I want to address that here. I want to address why Jordan Peterson is 100% wrong. You definitely can increase your intelligence. And this is from someone who likes Jordan Peterson. So I respect his opinion on many different topics. I've read his book, but on this particular topic, he is 100% wrong. So Jordan Peterson claims to have read all of the studies about increasing intelligence. And from that, he has concluded that you can't increase intelligence. So first of all, I don't know what studies he has read, because I have read all of the studies on increasing intelligence, and that's not what they say at all. So there's actually not that many studies on increasing intelligence. There's maybe 10 or 15. And if you read all those studies, it doesn't take long to read all of them. If you read all of them, you'll see that half of the studies show a significant increase in intelligence, and half of the studies show no benefit. So it's about 50-50. Half of the studies show a benefit, and half of the studies show no benefit. So even just reading the studies, even just a basic reading of the studies, you can conclude, okay, this is promising. It shows potential. So even if Jordan Peterson has just read the studies and then not really thought about how the studies were designed at all or anything like that, even just reading the studies, you should be concluding that this definitely has potential. So perhaps he hasn't read all of the studies like he claims. Perhaps he's only read one or two of the studies, and the one or two that he has read happened to be the one or two that showed no benefit. That's a possibility. Or perhaps his conclusions are just totally wrong. Like, I actually don't understand how Jordan Peterson can come to this understanding about increasing intelligence, because he's just 100% wrong here. So that's point number one, that if you just read the studies as they are, you will see that 50% of them show a significant increase in intelligence. And when you delve deeper into the studies, you can see that they're flawed in three main ways that actually make the potential benefit from training far higher than what the studies show. So the first way that they're flawed is that most of them are only based on a short duration. So they're based on maybe 4 to 12 weeks, so 1 to 3 months. That's what the average study duration was. So 1 to 3 months. So first of all, just imagine that you've never been to the gym before, and then you go to the gym for 1 to 3 months. Imagine how much stronger and fitter and more muscular you would be after just 1 to 3 months. Obviously, you would barely see the difference, isn't it? You would become a little bit stronger, a little bit fitter, but you would barely see the difference after 1 to 3 months. Because when you're training your body, and your mind is the same way, when you're training and you're trying to adapt and become stronger, you need to put in more than 1 to 3 months. This is a multi-year endeavor. If you want to become really strong and really fit, it takes multiple years. And brain training is exactly the same. If you want to become really intelligent, if you want to really increase your intelligence, you need to put in multiple years of effort. So that's the one kind of flaw of these studies, is that they're all based on a short duration. And even though they're all based on a short duration, still half of the studies show a significant increase in intelligence. But that's flaw number one. So I'm not sure why Jordan Peterson didn't factor that into his analysis at all. But the second flaw of these studies is that they're all based on dual NBAC. So dual NBAC is basically a weak form of NBAC. So the training that I have done to increase my intelligence is quad NBAC, which is basically a much harder version of dual NBAC. So all of the studies were based on effectively a weak form of brain training. And even though all the studies are based on a weak form of brain training, still half of them showed an increase in intelligence over a short duration of time. So imagine if all of these studies were based on an actual hard version of brain training, like an actual real form of training, but none of them were based on a hard, real form of training. They were all based on a weak form of training. And even still, they showed significant increase in intelligence. That's kind of the second flaw of these studies. And there's a third flaw in these studies that really paints the picture that the potential benefits of brain training are far greater than what these studies show. So the third kind of flaw in the studies is that they don't factor in motivation at all. So again, remember that these studies were based on 1 to 3 months of training time. So imagine you've never been to the gym before and you get told by someone, okay, we're doing a study, go to the gym for 1 to 3 months, train for maybe 1 hour per week, and that's it. But you have no motivation to go. Perhaps you're getting paid to go to the gym for 1 hour per week for 1 to 3 months. Like, how much results would you expect to see? Would you expect to be much stronger, fitter, more muscular after 1 to 3 months when you're not particularly motivated to get stronger or fitter? Now compare that to someone who has never been to the gym before, but they're really motivated to get stronger and fitter, and they go to the gym for the same amount of time, they put in the same amount of time. Like, who's going to get the benefits? Obviously the person who is motivated to get stronger and fitter and more muscular is going to see the benefits, and the person who is not motivated is going to see next to no benefits at all. But still, even though these studies didn't factor in motivation at all, then they still showed a significant increase in intelligence in half of the studies. So those are three major flaws in all of the studies. And if you factor that in, then it's really obvious that not only does this brain training increase intelligence, but the potential to increase intelligence is far greater than what these studies suggest. So really, I'm not sure what Jordan Peterson has based his opinion on. Perhaps he hasn't read all the studies, because if you read all the studies, this is really obvious. These conclusions are really obvious. So again, perhaps he has only read a few of the studies on increasing intelligence. He does claim to have read all of the studies. So perhaps he did it 10 years ago or something when most of the studies hadn't come out yet. So if he did it 10 years ago, then yeah, perhaps there might have only been one or two studies at that time that perhaps those studies didn't show much benefit. But I read all of the studies, I think it was about 4 years ago. And at that time, 4 years ago, this was really obvious to me. So half of the studies showed a significant increase in intelligence. But when you delve deeper into the studies and you can see that the participants weren't motivated at all, and it was a short duration for all these studies, and that they're based on dual NBAC, which is a weak form of training. When you factor that in, obviously that the potential to increase intelligence is massive. So it's not only that, but on top of that, I use that as the basis for why I started doing this brain training. And I started, I think, about 5 years ago now, and I increased my intelligence by at least 13 IQ points. So if you're interested, you can go back and watch my first video where I just outline like how I did the study on myself and how I proved that I increased my intelligence by 13 IQ points. I actually think I've increased it far higher since then. I think I'm up to about 20 IQ points gained at the moment. But yeah, even if you just take my original video where I just proved the original initial gain, I've proven at least 13 IQ points of gain so far. And other people have copied my same methods, because I basically outline everything I've done for free on this YouTube channel. Like, I'm not trying to make money off anyone here. Like, I basically just give out all my secrets for free. And other people have copied exactly what I've done, and other people have increased their intelligence to a similar level that I have done as well. So really, it's 100% proven right now. Like, there's no doubt at all. And I don't know why Jordan Peterson can still be claiming that you can't increase intelligence. Like, even if you ignore my proof, my personal proof that I have increased my intelligence, even if you ignore other people who have copied my methods, who have proven they've increased their intelligence, even if you ignore that and you just look at the studies, it's really obvious. Half of them show an increase in intelligence. And then you delve deeper into the studies and you can see that the potential is far higher than what the studies have shown. I think eventually, once my channel gets bigger, I might actually pay and do my own studies to really prove this out even more. But you need a lot of money for that, so that's something I'll do, you know, further down the line. I would need 100 participants, you know, really double-blind studies to prove it out. But really, I actually don't care about proving it anymore. Like, if you want to read the studies and you come to the conclusion that you can't increase intelligence, like, there's nothing I can do for you. Like, if you want to disbelieve that you can't increase it, for no reason when there's so much evidence that you can do it, then, you know, I'm not going to stop you. Like, that's less competition for me. If you don't want to increase your intelligence, that's fine by me, because that's one less person I have to compete against in the world. You know, the reason why I'm increasing intelligence is so that I gain a competitive advantage against everyone else, so that I can crush it in business and in trading. So really, I shouldn't be sharing these ideas at all, but, you know, I just find it too interesting that I just basically have to share it. But yeah, I don't know why Jordan Peterson thinks that. I invite him to watch this video and come back with a counter-argument. You know, I would honestly like to hear his opinion as to why he thinks that. Because so far, all I've heard is that he's read the studies and that's his conclusion. I haven't really heard, you know, why that's his conclusion, because it doesn't make sense at all. So yeah, if you would like to share this video, it would be good, because then hopefully Jordan Peterson can see it, because my channel is still very small, so probably he won't see this video. But I really would like to get his opinion, because again, I like Jordan Peterson. I respect his opinion on so many different topics, but on this topic, he is just completely wrong. So yeah, I'd like to get his thoughts and why he has that idea. And yeah, that's about it, guys. If you like this video, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel, and I'll keep you guys updated with more videos. Cheers, guys.